I wanted to kind of point out my makeup. I intentionally wore makeup that was, this is kind of a play of like tears or crying, which is, you know, I think a big part of grief. And for me, it's been a really difficult part of grief for me to be able to express. And oftentimes I have to kind of, I kind of have to play with the idea of crying or, I don't know if play is the right idea, but I know that I remember when I was younger, there were often times that I would wear glitter. And a big part of why I would wear glitter is that it would kind of, I don't know, it kind of helped me cope with the difficulties of life. It helped me feel like that could be what is seen first rather than potentially the pain or whatever. And then maybe we don't go there. I think that was an element of it. But I do recall very intentionally wearing glitter. I also wore glitter as a young person to deter people who might be sexually interested in me, which I think was really interesting. But I think that had to do with a little bit more of my own internalized transphobia and perceptions of femininity and attraction and all that, you know, all that crap. But, and I'm not sure why I shared that there, but I did. But glitter has been something that I've experienced, or sparkle, something I've experienced in different ways throughout my life. And so for me, sometimes it's really difficult for me to really sit with what is exactly what I'm exactly grieving about. And sometimes it's helpful for something outside of myself to kind of inspire that, and or even to like work it out. And so for me, sometimes doing makeup or doing art is a way that I can express my sadness, express my loss, remember things that have been difficult for me to remember. Also, one of the things that I found really helpful, so crying was something that I learned to not cry as part of my conditioning growing up as somebody who was raised as a man. And crying. And in particular, I had a trauma response in which I cried a lot. And so I got to a point where I stunted my ability to cry, which stunted me from a lot of emotions, which is kind of like a whole other thing. But if you're kind of have that similar response with life and with grief, some of the things that I found helpful in that time of my life was watching certain films or television that kind of reminded me of my story and my challenge or my grief and my loss. I used to watch the movie Rent a lot, which I think, you know, Rent for a lot of people is maybe not an ideal, like feel good, lift your spirit kind of film. But for me, that's what it was for some reason. And I think part of that is I really resonated with a lot of the characters. As a person living with HIV, so the fact that they all had HIV, but there was also a lot of the songs and the words that were spoken to each other and the feelings and the emotions that were happening throughout the show really helped me to emote and connect with those parts of myself that I really was struggling to connect with, like say in the real world. And I can tend to do that more so, right? Even just now I can say that I still kind of use that tool. I've been watching a lot of Pose. Pose is a TV show that has a lot of trans characters in it. And there's a lot of family dynamics as far as chosen family, as well as the families that we're grown into. And a lot of the characters have difficulty with their families of origin and their families understanding them. And really struggling with being in their life with them, wanting to be in one another's lives, loving one another, but not really knowing how to do that. And so for me, it's helpful for me to see these characters and hear these characters and what they're going through, because then I feel less isolated in what it is that I'm going through. Like, I don't feel like I'm the only one in the world, which we all know better than that, but that's often sometimes what happens. And that's when like grief and can kind of overtake me to a way in which I then shut off and I don't grieve at all. Join me next week, same time, same place. You can watch this live on YouTube on Sundays at 3:33 p.m. Mountain Standard Time, or you can watch anytime you like on YouTube, or you can listen wherever you listen to podcasts at A Queer Chaplain. Don't ever hesitate to direct message me or reach out to me if you'd like to get tea or be in conversation.